Fellow Workers of Paul, Part 3, by Dr. Earl White. Colossians chapter 4, verse 10 and 11. Aristarchus, my fellow prisoner, saluteth you, and Marcus, sister's son to Barnabas, touching whom ye received commandments, if he cometh unto you, receive him. And Jesus, which is called Justice, who are of the circumcision, these only are my fellow workers unto the kingdom of God, which have been a comfort unto me. Yes, 2 days ago we looked at Aristarchus, a man with commitment. Yesterday we looked at Marcus, a man who proved you could change. And today we're going to look at Jesus Justice, the man with a great name. We know very little about this man. He definitely was a Jewish Christian. He was also a comfort to Paul. I don't think he was named after Jesus our Savior, but after Joshua, which was of a common name among the Jews. Jesus is the Greek equivalent to the Hebrew name Joshua. Since we know so little about this man, I will not go further except to say that he had a great name. Then I'm going to make an application. Every one of us who are Christians are called Christians because we are followers of Jesus Christ. We do bear his name. James chapter 2 verse 7 says, "Do not they blaspheme that worthy name by which ye are called?" James says that we are called after his worthy name. James is criticizing Christians who honor the wealthy and socially prominent because of advantage. Read the context. Someone comes into the service, and you know he is wealthy, and you will begin to give special recognition to him because you know he might be able to help you somewhere down the line. Or, if he joins the church, that he will be a great giver. The poor man comes in, and you make no recognition of him, and your follow-up visits do not have the same priority as it does with the wealthy man. James says this is evil. God is no respecter of persons, and you should not be what James is saying. Now, you don't have to treat them both like dirt. Jesus would want us to treat them alike. We bear the name of Jesus. Do you know that, Christian? The knowledge of this will keep you clean and godly. I am ashamed when I hear the leaders of our nation who claim to be Christian and have no conviction about morality. Solomon said in Proverbs 30, verse 20, "Such is the way of an adulterous woman. She eateth, wipeth her mouth, and saith, I have done no wickedness." This is also true of a whoremonger. I want to ask you a question. What kind of a reputation does Jesus have because of you? Are we wearing his name honorably? John says in 1 John chapter 4, in the last part of verse 17, "As he is, so are we in this world." How involved is Jesus in the things I do? I'm not talking about, is he doing this with me? Or does he endorse what I'm doing? I'm talking about the kingdom he is operating here on this earth right now. He is on earth in the person of the Holy Spirit. Does his kingdom activities include Hollywood? I better not get into naming things. I'll let you do that so you won't miss what you do. What I'm saying is what he is right now and what we are in this world right now. That will change our lives if we let it. Jesus Justice was a man with a name. So are we. Are we bearing the name of Jesus with honor? May the Lord give us grace to bear his name and have a reputation for it. May the Lord bless these words to our hearts today.
Complete in me, no work of mine could take, dear Lord, the place of thine. Thy blood hath pardoned, bought for me, and I shall stand complete.